Hello everyone. Today let us study about properties of fluids. First of all, we have to understand what do you mean by fluids. Okay, matter, they exist in three forms: as solid, liquid and gases. So liquids and gases, they are collectively known as fluids. So what is the difference between these three states? The molecular structure is the main difference. Okay, solids, they are having so much of molecules and cohesive force is more in those molecules. Okay, so what will happen? They will be compact, rigid and will have a definite volume. Whereas liquids, they have lesser number of molecules. They have lesser cohesive forces. So they will take the volume of container in which it is taken. Okay, and gases, these are having least number of molecules and the cohesive force is also least here. So what will happen? So if you put gas in a container, it will fill the whole container. Okay, the given mass of gas will fill the whole container, whatever may be the volume of the container. That is regarding gases. So we have now studied about what do you mean by fluids. They are liquids and gases collectively. Now we will study about different properties of fluids. There are 9 properties we are studying here: density, specific weight, specific volume, specific gravity, bulk modulus and compressibility, viscosity, vapor pressure, surface tension and capillarity. Okay, now let us discuss each one separately. The first one is density. Density means mass by volume. Okay, mass per unit volume is called density. Mass we represent it in kilogram and volume we represent in meter cube. So the unit become kilogram per meter cube. And you can, this kilogram we represent by m and meter, that is length. So ml raised to minus 3 is its unit. Okay. Now density of water at 4 degrees Celsius is 1000 kilogram per meter cube. Okay. Now for gases, we will have a relation as pressure is equal to rho RT, where rho is the density. We represent density as rho. So as pressure increases, from this relation we can get, as pressure increases, density will increase. Also P is equal to rho RT means as T increases, rho will decrease. Okay. But liquids, they does not have any such relationship, or the there is no much effect of temperature or pressure on density. The next one is specific weight. Specific weight, the what is specific that we will put up. Okay, so weight is put up. Weight by volume is specific weight. Weight we represent as mg, mass into acceleration due to gravity, by volume. So m by volume, this term is called density. We have already discussed about density here. So rho into g is specific weight. So mg is represented, that is force, na? So or weight. So that unit is newton. By volume, unit is meter cube. So newton per meter cube it becomes. So rho g we will have for water. Rho is 1000 kilogram per meter cube. We have already studied that. Into g become 9.8 meter per second square. So this will together give you rho g as 9810 newton per meter cube. Now let us check the unit of this. Okay, kilogram per meter cube. See here, kilogram per meter cube, unit of rho into g, that is meter per second square. So cutting this, you will get kilogram by meter square, second square, or m l raised to minus 2 t raised to minus 2 r as the unit. Okay. Then the next one is specific volume. Specific volume, the volume is coming, na? So volume we will put up. So volume by mass. So the given the volume occupied by a given mass, that is called specific volume. So here for a mass, if it occupy different volume, what does that mean? This is always we are always concerned about gases, right? Because in a given mass, it can occupy different volumes or different kind of quantities of volume. Then that is meant to be for gases, right? So that is specific volume. That is always given for gases, because gases will take different volumes for a given mass of or given mass quantity of gas. Okay. Now the next one is specific gravity. Specific gravity means density of fluid by density of standard fluid. If we multiply that by g in both sides, we can cancel it out. It's just that simple. So that become rho g. Rho g means what? Weight density. So it can also be represented as weight density of fluid by weight density of standard fluid. So So what is the standard fluid? In case of liquid, we take this standard fluid as water, and in case of gas, we take this standard fluid as air. So specific gravity of water at 4 degrees Celsius is 1, and that of mercury at 4 degrees Celsius is 13.6. Then there is another term called relative density. Relative density is comparison between densities of two fluids. The second fluid need not be, or this need not be standard fluid. That is the difference. It's the comparison between two fluids. So that denominator is not a standard fluid. Okay, that is what we mean by relative density. We take a fluid and we compare it by another fluid. That is what it means. Okay. Then the next one is K and beta. K means bulk modulus of elasticity. We have studied this in mechanics of solids, that is compressive stress by volumetric strain. Let us consider a container like this. It is having fluid here. Okay, so this fluid here, we are giving pressure through a piston. Let the pressure be P. We represent P1 as P. The initial pressure P1 is P, and the volume contained here is V. That is V1 is equal to V. Now we are increasing the pressure, and incremental pressure dP is given. So the net pressure become P plus dP. So under this P plus dP, the volume is reducing by dV. Here the initial was till here, then it is now reducing till here. So the volume reduces by dV, and the final volume become V2. So here V2 is the final volume that become V minus dV, and the last pressure P2, final pressure P2 becomes P plus dP. Now we have to find out what is bulk modulus. Bulk modulus is compressive stress. Here the extra additional compressive stress, what we have given, dP, we have given. Okay, dP by volumetric strain, the change in volume by original volume. What is the change in volume? dV is the change in volume, and the original volume is V. So dV by dV. Here we put a negative sign because as the pressure is increasing, we are increasing the pressure by reducing the volume. That's why we are putting a negative sign over here. So the initial volume V is V1. So we will have dP as P2 minus P1 by minus of V2 minus V1 by V1. Okay. Now beta. Beta is compressibility. Okay. Compressibility is reciprocal of bulk modulus of elasticity. That is 1 by K or minus dV by V by dP. If we define these two terms, bulk modulus means change in pressure required to produce change in pressure on a given volume of fluid to produce a change in volume as dV. I repeat. Change in pressure required for a given volume V to change the volume by dV. Okay, now compressibility. From this, we can define it. The amount of volume change produced by a given incremental pressure dP. Okay, that is compressibility. Now, the next term is viscosity. Viscosity is very important. Okay, when two layers of fluid are flowing, the resistance offered by one layer over the adjacent layer is called viscosity. So viscosity is the internal resistance offered by one fluid layer to the movement of adjacent fluid layer. Okay, this is a very important topic. Viscosity is due to cohesion and molecular momentum transfer. Okay. See, let us take it as MMT, okay, molecular momentum transfer. So cohesion, this is important in case of liquids. Okay, liquid is mainly, cohesion is mainly governed in liquids, and molecular momentum transfer is mainly governed in gases. So as temperature increases in case of liquids, we know, for example, water, if temperature is increasing, the attraction between particles, that is its cohesion, that will reduce. So if that reduces, then what will happen? The viscosity will reduce because viscosity depend upon cohesion. But in gases, where molecular momentum transfer is important, when temperature increases, this gas molecule collides more. So because of the collision, molecular momentum transfer will increase, and because of that, viscosity will increase. Now suppose we are taking some examples, okay, for increasing order of viscosity. Gasoline is less viscous than water, that is less viscous than crude oil, and castor oil is having the most viscosity among these four. Okay, so this is important in point of some questions or some objective questions, which is having more viscosity. Like that, the questions may be asked. Okay, Now the next one, we are doing the derivation of this. See here, there is a plate. This is a plate. Okay, here this element is a plate. Here over the fixed surface, this is moving, or this element is moving. Here there is fluid particles, and here because of the shear force F, we are moving this. Okay, so velocity V is attained by this plate or this element. So let us here. There is an element here which is having a sheet here. Okay, let us take it as a sheet or a layer having initial velocity u, and supposed at a distance of dy we have another layer here. This is the layer that is having velocity as u plus du. Okay, now this is having d theta angle. What d theta is? The shear strain here, so, or angular deformation here. So let us take this element, this small element. So here it becomes du, na? This element is du. The small element is du, having du as initial velocity or change in velocity, or the velocity of this small element. And here the distance become dy, and here this is d theta. So in this element, d theta is equal to this distance by this distance. No? So this is du is the velocity. So into time will give you the distance. That is, velocity into time will give you the distance. So you will have d theta is equal to the du into dt by dy. So if you take this side, d theta by dt is equal to du by dy. So we will have d theta by dt, that is rate of shear strain or rate of angular deformation. This theta, d theta is called shear strain or angular deformation. So dt of that become rate of shear strain or rate of angular deformation. That is equal to du by dy here. So du by dy is called velocity gradient. See, from here you can find out the unit of this. See, d theta by dt, d theta does not have any unit. By dt means it is, dt unit is second. So 1 by second or second raised to minus 1 becomes the unit of this. Okay. Then force is equal to the shear force we are giving. That now, that is proportional to d theta, right? So force is proportional to d theta by dt. So shear force is directly proportional to shear stress. That is, tau is equal to F by area, shear force by area. So area is constant here, so we will have shear stress proportional to d theta by dt, or shear stress proportional to du by dy. So if you remove the proportionality, there will become a constant comes nu. So that nu constant is called coefficient of dynamic viscosity. So dynamic viscosity nu is represented as tau by d theta by dt, and d theta by dt is rate of shear strain. So tau unit is Newton per meter square, and d theta by dt unit is second raised to minus 1. So the unit become Newton second per meter square. So that becomes the SI unit of dynamic viscosity. Now if we split this, Newton become Newton means force into A. That is, A is acceleration due to gravity or acceleration. Okay. So here N becomes kg meter per second square. M, A. Okay, so second by meter square. So if we cancel out these terms, that will come out to be kg by meter second. That can be represented as kg is m, meter length, and s is second. So second is t, we represent it as c, t. So it becomes m l raised to minus 1, t raised to minus 1. Okay, now that kg meter per meter second, that if you convert into gram centimeter second or cg as units, that becomes 1000 gram by 100 centimeter into second. So that will become 10 gram by centimeter second. That is its cg as unit, which is called as poise. So we'll have 1 kilogram by meter second is equal to 10 poise. So viscosity, dynamic viscosity of water at 1 degree Celsius is 1 centipoise, or 1 by 100 poise. So that is regarding the properties of fluids. We have studied almost half of the portion. We'll study the remaining half in the next video lecture. Thank you so much for watching my video. If you like this video, do share, subscribe, and press the bell notification.